So we're here in beautiful Croatia. My gosh, look at this. Our lovely big charter catamaran. And let's talk a little bit about a proper lookout and some collision avoidance situations. Most importantly of all, risk of collision. Because I know from all my clients, all of you, that's the bit that freaks you out. When you get out of your marina, sometimes even before you get out of your marina, you're faced with a whole mass of other boats. Kayaks, jet skis, and you all freak out, and quite understandably, it's very intimidating. Am I going to hit that one? Am I going to hit that one? And then your crew members are trying to be helpful with good heart, and they say, there's a jet ski, there's a paddleboard, there's a sailboat. You go, okay. And so you can very easily be overwhelmed and very intimidated. So rule 7 is the risk of collision, okay? And before we get to rule 7, let's just talk a little bit about a proper lookout, okay? The collision rules define a proper lookout. Every vessel shall at all times maintain a proper and effective lookout by sight and hearing, as well as all available means, meaning radar, appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions to determine if there's a danger of a collision, right? So, a proper lookout, you actually have to move your head. If you're not going very fast, check behind you now and again. Before you make a big alteration of course, always check over your shoulder that there isn't someone coming flying up your side that you're going to turn into. So a proper lookout is always effective. Now, let's turn our attention to this boat here. Rule 7, risk of collision. So, I'm a power-driven vessel. He's a power-driven vessel. He's on my starboard bow, so I would be give way to him. But now let's just put the camera on him and take a look at him and decide, in fact, is there a risk of collision? And so what you see is the relative movement between us going forwards and him going forwards. It seems fairly clear that in fact, if we looked at him with a compass, he's tracking left to right. There is bearing movement. He's getting closer, that's true. But he's also, and we can see it more clearly now, he's clearly going sideways and is going to pass clear down the side of our boat. So there's no risk of collision. We didn't need to do anything. We kept an eye on him, of course, but there was no risk of collision. We didn't need to do anything. So now let's go up through the channel up here. There's a lot more boats, and let's see what we can find.